Okay, good morning children. So today we are doing lesson 8, honeycomb. All of you open your honeycomb, page number 114 and 115. So to fire is both. You know fire, no? Useful and dangerous. What is fire? How did we discover it? How do we control it? Okay? Fire, friend and foe. That means friend and enemy also. Early man didn't know what fire was. But he must have seen the damage it could cause. He must have watched lightning and volcanoes long before he began to use fire himself. Okay, early man had seen fire, but they have not used it. Fire was powerful and dangerous. And he was frightened. Man was frightened of fire, okay? Fire may have puzzled early man. Early man used to be puzzled. Here, what is this? Asu chen thai, okay? But we now know that fire is the result of a chemical reaction. When the oxygen in the air combines with carbon and hydrogen in a fuel, a chemical reaction takes place. Energy in the form of heat and light is released in this process. You know this, this comes in science. Yes, whatever. This is what we call fire. Three things are needed to make fire. How will we make fire? Fuel, oxygen and heat. Wood, coal, cooking gas and petrol are some examples of fuel. Oxygen comes from the air. Okay, what do we take in? Oxygen. What do we give out? Do you know? Okay, see now, that is why when we blow on smoldering paper, it often bursts into flame. For example, papers you burn and just keep them. And by mistake, when you blow, phook maro, so what will happen? Fire will be there. It often bursts into a flame. The third thing needed to make fire is heat. Fuel and oxygen do not make fire by themselves. Fuel and oxygen, it will not make fire, but we need something else for it. Or else a paper or a stick lying in the open will catch fire on its own. To burn a piece of paper or wood, we heat it before it catches fire. We generally do it with a lighted match. Match stick cover, divasadi. Every fuel has a particular temperature at which it begins to burn. All are having their different temperatures. This temperature is called the flash point or kindling temperature of the fuel. It is sometimes said that fire is a good servant but a bad master. If you control the fire, it is good. If the fire controls you, it is bad. Okay? It is sometimes said that fire is good. Okay, it only means that fire is a very useful as long as it is kept under control. For instance, we use it to cook our food, warm our homes in winter and to generate electricity. Both, on the other hand, if fire gets out of control, it can be very dangerous. Each year, thousands of homes and shops are damaged by fire. Vast areas of forest are also destroyed. And hundreds of people are killed or injured by fire. Just as three things are needed to start a fire, there are three main ways in which a fire can be put out. Okay, you can extinguish also, put it out also. How? In each one of the three things needed for burning is taken away. Now page number 116. For example, we can take away the fuel. If the fire has no fuel to feed on, no burning can take place. We often let a fire die out simply by not adding more fuel to it. Something we burn, charcoal, samjho, kolsa. Then you don't put anything, don't give it air. Then it will slowly extinguish by itself. It will die itself. The second way of putting out a fire is to prevent oxygen from reaching it. Oxygen should not reach it. No supply of oxygen means no fire. No oxygen, no fire. Small fires can be put out or smothered with a damp blanket or a sack. Damp means beanie. Beanie blanket, if you put on the fire, it will damp, it will stop burning. Or a sack, sack means kothro. This stops oxygen reaching the burning material. Sometimes carbon dioxide is used to extinguish fire. It does not allow oxygen to reach the burning material. The third way of putting out a fire is to remove the heat. If the temperature can be brought down below the flash point, the fuel stops burning. You blow on a burning matchstick or a candle to put it out. In doing so, you remove the hot air around the flame, bringing down its temperature below the flash point, and the candle goes out. Sometimes water is sprayed on a fire. It absorbs heat from the burning fuel and lowers the temperature. The blanket or water also cuts off the supply of oxygen, and the fire is extinguished. Some fires cannot be put out with water. If water is sprayed onto an oil fire, the oil will float to the top of the water and continue to burn. Okay? Oil ma aag lagi hoy, so it will not extinguish by water. This can be very dangerous because water can flow quickly, carrying the burning oil with it and spreading the fire. Water should also not be used on fires caused by electrical appliances. The person spraying water might receive an electric shock and be killed. A carbon dioxide extinguisher is the best thing to fight an electrical fire. Children, shall I continue? Yeah. Page number 117. Open everybody, we are completing the lesson. It's short only. And 118. Yeah. We spend millions of rupees each year in fighting fires. And we spend more trying to find new ways of preventing fires. We don't want fires to be there, so we try to find out new ways, new methods from happening and getting out of control. On the whole, we have learned rather well to control fire. Today we know how to control fire and put it to good use in our everyday life. Long ago, there were no firemen. Today, when fire is there, we call the fire brigade, no? When fire broke out, everybody became a firefighter. People formed human chains. Human chains means everybody will be in a line together, turn by turn. And they still do it and pass buckets of water from a well or a pond to the blaze. Blaze means where there is a fire. Now there are laws about building construction which ensure that space is left between buildings to reduce the fire risk. Every new building, especially a public place, must ensure observance of fire prevention norms. Bands of fire fighting workers with special equipment known as the fire brigades are there to put out fires. Firefighters are highly trained people. They are trained very well. They possess many skills. They cut off electricity supply, knock down dangerous walls. If there is a fire, they will stop the supply of electricity. They spray water, they knock down the walls also if too much fire is there. And then they spray water and other materials to bring fire under control. They are also trained in first aid. See, this is a chain. Yeah. Now, last page, children. They can help people suffering from burns. By chance somebody is burned, so there are first aid. They know how to use or from the effects of smoke. Too much smoke is there, there will be suffocation. Then first aid people will help. The discovery of fire and its uses helped early men to cope with nature better and gradually adopt a settled mode of life. Fire is still worshipped. We worship no fire, diva kariye ne apne, in many parts of the world. Fire is indeed a friend, but as we know, it can be a dangerous enemy once it gets out of control. Okay, children, so this lesson is completed. I'll be sending you the PDF, okay? And then there will be a test that I'll let you know. Okay, bye, children.